One. So today I'm going to go ahead and start to pull the engine out of my car. So I can pull the motor out of the engine bay and swap the accessories over and then put the new motor inside of the engine. Wire it all up and then pretty much turn it on. So,
okay, so the first thing I did was jack the car up and put it on jack stands. Then I went ahead and removed the two front wheels off the car. So that way I could get access to pull off the bumper and make things a whole lot easier for me. So one of the most important steps is to make sure the doors are unlocked, and you could put the windows down, but I prefer to leave mine up. Also, to open the trunk and make sure to leave it open. Just for the simple fact that now we're gonna go ahead and disconnect the battery, which is over here.
So we're gonna use is a 10 millimeter socket and take this nut off and just move this negative terminal off. Don't mind, mine's having like a lot of extra wires, mainly due to have a amp wired into the car right here. Okay, so now you should have the belly pan removed from off the car. It should be like an 8 millimeter socket you'll need to take them all off. So take the whole thing off, even the ones up inside of the wheel wells also.
Next, we're gonna go ahead and drain the oil out of the car using a 17 millimeter socket. I already loosened it a bit, so where is it? So use a 17. Make sure your canister is in the location approximate near it, and have the part open or whatever. Make sure the breather is open too, and yeah, just loosen it out. Preferably, it'd be nice if the engine was a little bit warmer so that it makes sure it drains out everything a little bit more smoother. So, yeah. And here we go.
Okay, so I'm gonna start removing the bumper now. So I'm gonna use a T30 socket to remove these four bolts up here. Not bolts, but hex heads or something like that. 1, 2, 3, 4. Remove these. And then underneath the bumper, on these two spots about here and here, there should be two screws. Go ahead and remove them, and there'll be two screws on the other side also. Make sure to disconnect the fog lights connectors at the bottom, like one over here and one over here. And after that, you could go ahead and just pull the bumper right off.
Okay, so since this is automatic, just gonna disconnect the transcooler from the fan assembly. So you're gonna use a T20 and just take this bolt off, and then once it's out, just go ahead and move it over to the side.
Okay, so we should be disassembling the fan right now. So there's a bolt over here. It's use a T20 also to take it off, and also to take off the power plug. You just squeeze and pull up on this and it'll come right out. Then on this piece right here, this like hook looking thing, all you do is just pull it forward in that direction and pull up. Once those are disconnected, you can pull the fan right out. And normally this line right here would run across here over to the reservoir. Make sure to lift it off with a fan assembly before you do anything. So I have this piece off, just move this over to the side, and then the screws out, and I pulled on the tab forward to get it loose, and I'm gonna just wiggle and pull up and it'll come out. Okay, so now I'm gonna drop the intercooler. I'm just gonna disconnect these bolts right here and drop the intercooler and another one over there in the corner, those clamps. And depending on if you have a stock intercooler, most likely it'll be just those pull clips or whatever. Just pull the clip out and it should drop right out. Then when you're underneath the car, you just use a T20 on the bolt over here. And where is it? Right here. So once those are loose, then the intercooler should go ahead and drop quite easily. So it's good to at least have a jack right here so you can just lower the intercooler down. Or if you feel you're strong enough, just go ahead and pull it down by hand. These are the best clamps to use on intercooler pipings. They really create a good seal. I've yet to have a boost leak ever using these clamps right here. I forgot where I got them from. Here we are. So these are down, and we can go ahead and start taking apart using the T20 and removing these. And the intercooler should be able to freely drop down now. Okay, so now I'm about to go ahead and drain the coolant out the car. So I have my bucket ready, and I have a wide flat head. And I'm just gonna go ahead here and just turn inside here where the grooves are at. So you turn in there, and then finally when it comes up, it'll start to drain off into the bucket. Okay, so with the drain bolt moved out the way, I'm gonna go ahead and loosen the expansion tank, and you should be hearing coolant dropping into the bucket now. So now that the coolant is drained, I'm gonna go ahead and disconnect the connectors to take out the radiator. And apparently I'm leaking, like there's a leak somewhere here. Usually it just cracks, these crack up here on the OEM ones, but on this one, it just like the whole side right here just like leaking, which is odd. I'm guessing it's from up here. But either way, let's go ahead and use a flathead and pull those clips out that way. And the same thing for the bottom one. So there's two hoses. So just use a flathead and just pull them out like that. And then just pull up on the connectors. And the same thing here, you just use a T20, take the screw off, and this will just come right off. And this takes the automatic transmission oil, what was it? Coolant cooler or oil cooler? Yeah, the oil cooler for the transmission from the radiator. Man, this radiator really sucks. It's even leaking from over here too. But it seems like it's a small leak. I really didn't even notice I'm losing coolant. So I'm just using the flathead right here and sticking it up and pull, and there you go, it's up right now. And let's wiggle it. So yeah. Oh man, got some water all over me. But yeah, that's loose right now. Let me pull this up so it don't keep leaking coolant. On top, do the same thing here. Like so. Now, this one will be a little bit harder to take off since it's a lot bigger. But main thing to do is hold it from up here and just keep wiggling it. So I'm gonna do this with two hands. So the way I got it off was just jiggle it left and right, up and down. So think of it like an old Nintendo cheat code or something like that.
Up, up, down, down, left, right, left, right, B, A.
What is this cheat for?
It's for call an ambulance,
Left, right, and just pull. So up, down, left, right, and jiggle it and pull up, and it'll come right out. So a little bit more coolant is coming out. So on over to this side, I'm gonna go ahead and use a T20 and get it out of the way. So I said forget about using the T20 and taking this bolt off. I'm just gonna go ahead and make life a lot easier and just use the flathead and pull this one up and take it off and leave this connected to the radiator. I got a new radiator, I'm just gonna go ahead and just swap this piece over to the new one. But yeah, the space right here to put the socket is just, yeah, just a pain to deal with. So this part, doing it this way will be a lot more easier. And there we are, disconnected. So right here. Now I'm gonna go ahead and remove the upper radiator hose and this attachment right here for the expansion tank. Generally this would be running on its other side, so it wouldn't even look like this, but the hard brittle line that always breaks is eliminated. So I really love the way just relocating over to this side just to eliminate that is like the greatest thing ever on this car, because it just eliminated another headache or point of failure that could occur. So all you're gonna use is just the flathead right here. Pull it up and then wiggle off, and then pull that up. I'm gonna use two hands. So can't take this one off for now. I'm gonna move on because I don't wanna break anything. So go ahead and lift this piece up, and underneath here should be another one also. So yeah, that one's clipped out also. So gonna pull this one down right here and pull this one out. And then lastly, just go ahead and pull this one out also. So I'm gonna go ahead and try and get this all out right now. So last thing we gotta do is take off this bolt right here. This bolt right here is a T20. So there's one here, and also one over here in the corner, in here. So once you take those two bolts out, you can go ahead and easily just pull out the rail. So now all you gotta do is just pull up and yeah, just pull up and you should be able to get the radiator out. So I'm gonna go ahead and use two hands to do this since I don't really want to mess up any lines or anything like that. Okay, so now for the condenser, I'm just gonna go ahead and disconnect the fittings that attach it to the car. So right over here, you should see like a tab. So right here, you just like lift up and pull out, and then this part will come loose. And then on this side, you see this little yellow thing? Just go ahead and pull this way and it'll come right out like so. And that pretty much have the condenser loose. Okay, so the next thing we're gonna use is a 6mm, I forgot what you call this thing. Something that looks like this. So it's a 6mm, and you go ahead and just take off these two bolts right here, and then you can go ahead and just pull out the condenser. But the only thing is, if you have refrigerant still inside the lines, it's gonna start to leak out. So it's not, I don't believe, don't call me on this, I think you could just go ahead and like evacuate it just like that. You don't have to bring it to a shop or anything.
Wrong.
I already went ahead and had mines evacuated, so I'm just gonna go ahead and just take these bolts off and move it aside. Okay, so with these two bolts out, go ahead and move the AC lines out the way. I might start to screw these in so I know. Actually, anytime I take a screw out, I generally just put it back in so that I know exactly where it goes back in later on. So right inside here, there's another screw, a T20. That's the last thing holding this condenser to it. So the screw's out now, so that's everything holding on the condenser. So I'm gonna just go ahead and pull it out now. That's good. Wow.
Little honeybee on there. Not a honeybee, that just looks like a wasp.
Okay, so next thing I'm gonna go ahead and do is remove the headlights. So just gonna go ahead and disconnect the right here. Disconnect the power, just so you just push in at the sides and just pull out. And same thing here. Pull them out the way. Now you just use a T30. So you take off this screw, and move these out the way. These two right here. Same thing over here. Take these screws out of here, and these two right here. So once all those are taken out, then you can go ahead and pull the headlights out.
Now the bolts all out, let's go ahead and pull this out. And here we are.
All out. Almost everything is off the front radiator support piece, this part of here that I'm trying to take off right now. And yeah, the only thing left is just the coolant level sensor over here that was rerouted from the passenger side of the car to the driver side of the car. So I'm just gonna move that over to the passenger side and then disconnect the hood latch. And then we should be ready to pull off the support. So follow this and start to pull these out right here. I just tucked them into right here. this connected. Move it over to here. And out the way. So the only thing I see left now is just the hood latch. So to take the hood latch off, it's gonna go ahead up to this box right here. So what you gotta do is just use a flathead and pretty much pry up on it. So I think the easiest way is just to pull it off the connection grommet it has right here, and then use the flathead and lift it up from here. Okay, so once it's pried open, you just go ahead and swing this up, and then you just take this wire right here, lift it out, pry it out, and there you go. Disconnected from the body. Okay, so now I'm gonna start disconnecting the wires that's on the front face of the bumper support right here. So hot. Made in USA. Wow. So there's gonna be a sensor back here. Let's go ahead and push down on it and pull up. And I'm gonna move these out the way. So. And leave it over here to the side. And then here for the horn, pull this out. Move it over to the side like so. And then for the next horn, pull it out also, and this piece would be going to the fog light connection. Just hand those over to the side, and that's everything that's connected to the bumper support. Now I'm gonna go ahead and take off these bolts right here to take off the brake duct air ram system or something like that. I don't know what to call it. Same thing over here, do the same thing. So the main reason I'm taking it off so that I can access these bolts right here in the back a little bit more easier. Back here. So with the brake ducts disconnected, I can go ahead and get at these bolts right here. So it'll be these two here, these two right here, and these two here, and those two over here. So I'm gonna use a 13 millimeter and take these bolts off. Okay, so with those screws out right now, both sides are out. I'm gonna go ahead and take off these two screws right here and these two screws over here with a 10 millimeter. So once I take these off, then I can easily just pull off the whole front end of the car right now. So I had to use two hands to get this off, but it's off now after I release those bolts. Yeah, the only thing left right now is just this. I don't know what this is, but it looks like you just pop this out right here, and then these thing, this was what's holding in the condenser frame. Move those off to the side. You can just take these off. You might could just leave them, but I think I'm just gonna take them off so I don't have any obstructions when the motor is coming out this way. So with the front clip off, the first phase of getting the engine out is completed. So the next time I start back working on this, I'm gonna go ahead and start disconnecting the ECU wires over here and just have them swung over. And then the next phase would be disconnecting the drive shaft from the transmission and unbolting the transmission support mounts and the engine mounts and hook it up to the hoist and pull it out. So yeah, once I do those wires and disconnecting some of the wires over here, like the fuel connection that goes to the high pressure fuel pump down there, we should be good to go. So the biggest hurdle was pretty much taking off this front end right here. It's a lot of components. So stay tuned and subscribe, like, comment, and I'll make sure to respond. So take it easy.